Everyone has to sleep at night. What really happened, Clay, after he tells himself all that?
I just told you.
No, tell me the truth.
He goes on. He lives. He writes as well as he can. He's a big success.
Bullshit. I'm not talking about the book. You're just avoiding. Tell me the truth. What are you afraid of, Clay?
Look, why don't you tell me?
What?
I want to know what you think. You're so smart. You got yourself in here. You got me talking. Acting so precocious, throwing your little ass around, quoting Shakespeare, and batting your eyelashes. Why don't you tell me? I want to know what you think. What happens to them?
No.
You tell me what happens to Rory and Dora, or you can get the hell out.
He's fucked.
Now go on.
Maybe he can forget. Maybe he can write, create. But it doesn't matter because he'll never, ever believe it. He's robbed himself of the chance to find out.
Not bad.
Or maybe he can't write, although he's been able to fool a few people.
Even better.
Maybe his marriage falls apart because for him and his wife to look at one another is for them to look at the truth. And maybe when he goes in public, he can wear that mask of confidence and sophistication. But back when he's alone, late at night, he can't sleep. Because when he closes his eyes, he still sees the face of that old man.
Maybe he sees his own face. And the old man is just a story he made up. Or maybe he finds himself in his beautiful New York apartment overlooking the park with a girl who's much too young for him, and he's telling her what he knows to be our tired old stories. Because for some reason, she believes that he has something to give her. You're very talented, Daniela. But at some point, you have to choose between life and fiction. The two are very close, but they never actually touch. They're two very, very different things.